again. The best in architectural design in Otago is being recognised at a function in Dunedin this evening. Not surprisingly, Dunedin's redeveloped octagon has earned an award for works consultancy services, and several buildings have also won awards. Now, this certainly isn't your typical seedy student housing. It's the university block in Cumberland Street, which has won an award for Simon Anderson and Brian Elliott Associates. The judges were impressed with the way the old and new have been integrated. A building of quite a different kind across town in Anderson's Bay Road. It houses connoisseur cars, and, say the judges, puts cars on show and does it well. It was designed by Mason and Wales. In June, former Dunedin City Councillor Jean McLean opened the pavilion that bears her name, and now it's won an award for Allingham, Harrison and Partners for the way in which it fits into its surroundings. And now it's up to Queenstown, to the Wakatipu Kindergarten, designed by MJ Wyatt. It's described as a joyful building, but sadly may not now meet the new minimum standards for preschool buildings as laid down by the Ministry of Education. Unlike some northern polytechnics, the two in our region aren't having any trouble attracting full-time students for next year. Otago Polytech has had to turn students away from its three main full-time courses, nursing, physiotherapy and tourism, despite big student fee increases. It expects to have about 1,000 full-time students in 1990, about the same as this year. Southland Polytechnic isn't as far advanced with its enrolments, but has again had to turn away people from its comprehensive nursing course. A roll of around 500 is expected again next year. Both say it's too early to know what effect the fees will have on part-time courses. A handful of access trainees in Dunedin have proved themselves over the past few months to be boat builders. What would normally take an apprentice 5 years to achieve, they've done in just 5 months. Cathy Graham with the story.
Over the past few months, this Port Chalmers shed has gradually filled with boats. The real job at hand was to build a schooner, but that's been put aside while the smaller boats have multiplied. The idea was to give each access worker an incentive, a boat each, and it's worked. This one will go on display at next week's boat show. It's a 14-foot rowing wherry, the old name for the old style. And it's been built by people with no previous boat building skills.
I haven't really taught these people anything. I've allowed them to learn how to do it. Okay, it's quite a different process. Give them the room and let them play, and that's what they do.
Nevin McLaughlin used to be a meat inspector until he lost his job when the Burnside Works closed. He couldn't get an apprenticeship, but this course has given him the woodworking skills he wanted and the prospect of continuing work.
We've got another boat on the drawing board, and things are looking promising for a start in the new year with that.
Jonathan Todd says that although the access schemes probably cost the company money, it's given them lots of fun, beautiful boats, and the skills to hopefully make lots more.
Great news. The public's being asked to dig deep this week for Koru Care, the group that helps send sick children on overseas trips. Three cyclists wheeled down into Dunedin this afternoon on a 2,000-kilometre, month-long ride that's taken them from Wanaka up the west coast. They'll collect in Southland and Queenstown before finishing back in Wanaka next Saturday. So far, the trio's collected more than $3,000. They hope to double this before they finish. A North Island expert on financial systems called Green Dollars is talking to Southern groups interested in the idea. Green Dollars allows members to barter what they have in goods and services around an extensive pool. A Dunedin group called Coastal Otago Barter System is getting underway, and Lee Davies looks at how it'll work.
In our society, if you don't have money or cheques or credit cards, you can't really participate in the economy. Retailers won't give you the basics of life unless you have the money to pay for them. Especially in times of high unemployment, when lots of people have no money but plenty of skills, there's room for a different system. David James is in Dunedin advising the local group COBS on how to set that system up. It means people can offer skills or produce in return for credits, and then exchange the credits for the items they need rather than for cash. In many places, the system already works on a casual basis. One of the technicians at work fixes your TV in the lunch hour, and you do some typing for her after work. She gives you the surplus from her tomato crop, and you treat her to your spectacularly good chocolate square. In the green dollar system, it simply means the pool of goods and services is much larger.
What about the business community? Is there a small business group within the Chamber of Commerce? And if so, is it in touch with a wide range of people? If so, worth talking to?
While David continues his tour to talk to other groups throughout the region, the Dunedin Committee will set up a trial system that'll run until April. If it's successful, this may be how things work in the future.
Hello, can I help you?
I've come to pay my monthly instalment.
Ha-ha, but how are they going to pay the tax? In California, it's the latest, it's super cool, everybody's doing it. And in the words of the man who brought it to New Zealand, it's like out of the 20th century. Rocket-powered surfboards, salt and sand-proof videophones. No, man, Michael Brown found out these things go on your feet.
In Cathedral Square, Christians and anti-Christians were in full cry, little realising that behind them, Bruce Jackson was about to steal their show.
God's on my side. He's like helping me lace up my skates.
Introduce a roller skate to a consenting ice skate, and you get a roller blade. And that's what Bruce Jackson is here to promote. On the rough tiles, the ramps moved more easily than he did.
That's nice, huh?
But with the help of City Council furniture, he took it all in his stride.
Ladies and gentlemen. The United States.
In the United States, he says he's number one, and that means the one with the most TV spots, movie appearances, and commercials. In his own words, he's the most focused.
Unlike a traditional roller skates, the skates are more maneuverable, so you get really good footage shooting films on them and coordinating stunts. You can really get some really cool stunts out of the skates. And a lot of people are using them because they're state-of-the-art product right now. It's something that looks like it's about the 25th century, you know, like you're in space.
He says it's like floating on a cloud. And he's done the long white one, starting in Queen Street, Auckland.
I got the potential to make it go then chill. I got the credential that if the we said chill to make a rap and chill, then you know why.
Here in Christchurch, he stole the whole audience, Christians and all. And what showman on wheels could resist a victory like that?
Hey, man, I think I'll shoot away for a bit of super cool super blading for the weekend. You have a nice one, and we'll see you again on Monday. Good night.